Welcome back, everyone. My next guest. Not only is she one of my very nicest clients, she's also my sponsor. I have with me Anna von Straussenburg, and she is the owner of L. Anna von Straussenburg CPA. Welcome to the show. I am so happy to have you here with me today. And you have a lot of things that you like to talk about, because tax season isn't just in April.
Oh, no.
No.
We're still continuing on because, we put a number of people on extension. Some people was just, we got a rush at the last minute, and I just couldn't get it all done. But once they're on extension, we got a little time. And then there's the procrastinators.
Oh, yeah.
And so, some people don't come in till August or even September. And the reminder I have is that business tax returns are due September 15th, and trust returns are due normally September 30th, but it falls on a weekend, so October 2nd is the date.
Okay.
And then individual returns are due October 15th. So
here, today you said you wanted to talk about a few things, but I always like to start off about talking about you. Okay. Number one, excellence and integrity in accounting is your tagline. And it's not just your tagline. It is your way of life.
Oh, it definitely is. I always strive to do the best job I can possibly do. I research the heck out of stuff, and I always stand by my work. And if mistakes happen, and unfortunately we're human and things happen,
right,
I will stand by my work, and I will cover any penalties that result from it.
You also were very recently, you were up for the Torch Award from the Better Business Bureau. And I bring this up because not very many people get that is a very, not only just nominated, right? That in itself is kudos to you for that. This year you're going to win. I know it. I stuffed the ballot box, so I just wanted you to know.
Well, unfortunately, I didn't make it to the finals.
Yeah, but
I was nominated and went through the process. And I think partly is my business, even though I've been in the same location for over 20 years, I only took over my business at the end of 2019, so I'm relatively new. I bought my business from my former employer, who was more of a mentor than just an employer, and he groomed me to take over the business, because even though he has two sons that are accountants and one is a CPA, they didn't want the business. One, it lives on the East Coast and didn't want to move, and the other one, well, he just doesn't really like accounting all the time. He'll do it for short periods of time, but he just prefers a more physical job. So I got the opportunity, and I'm blessed to have the opportunity.
Anybody that works with Anna is going to know that she's a numbers person. She absolutely loves it. You, as a matter of fact, I'm going to just say it out loud right now. You kind of like to admit that you're a nerd, right?
Yeah.
A little bit, and that's okay. But you know what? That's the kind of person that you want working with for you. And she works hand in hand with her clients. They become family. Not only that, you are teaching them. You are actually helping them understand their numbers. So because when they understand their numbers, they understand their business is going to grow.
Yes. I mean, the bottom line is you're in business to make money. But if you're not tracking your expenses properly or your income properly or looking what your debt is, you're not knowing whether you're making money, and you don't know how you can plan to do better or plan to avoid some taxes. There's always that element, and so I always try to be proactive with my clients and look at their books 3 times a year. I come in July, and I like to see the books for 6 months, and then again in November, I'd like to see it all the way through the end of October and try to get numbers for November and kind of project out December, and we get as close as we can to what the person might owe if they don't make any changes.
So you're prepared.
So we're prepared. And so some people, that's a moment we can talk about some tax planning. Do you want to fund your retirement plan? Do you need to buy more assets? What can you do to to help yourself out.
Now, her phone number to call, it's area code 480-964-4030. That's 480-964-4030. She does free consultations with everyone. She works nationwide. She also is rated with the Better Business Bureau. Check her out on her website. It's ArizonaCPAsWithAnS.com. Now, you mentioned tax planning. Do you want to start kind of talking a little bit about that first of the things that you wanted to talk about?
Yeah, I think that's a good idea. One of the things I kind of refreshed my brain on is that one of the tax planning strategies you can do is to fund some kind of retirement plan. And there's a bunch of them out there. And for small businesses, actually for any business, you can do what they call a SEP, which is a simplified employee pension plan. And that one you can contribute quite a bit to, I believe up to $66,000. It's 25% of your net income. And sometimes it has to be, depending on how your business is set up, it may need to be adjusted for self-employment tax, but it's roughly 20 to 25%. And then there's a simple plan, which, you know, in my head, sometimes when I, you know, hear that the SEP is a simplified plan, and then the simple plan has that name.
They're like so close.
They're close in name, but they're very different. A simple plan operates a little more like a 401k, where if you have employees, they can also contribute to the plan, whereas the SEP, they cannot. But then the contribution limits are lower. So there's give and take with everything. And likewise, you know, an individual can contribute to a deductible IRA, or you can contribute to a Roth IRA. And, you know, where I come in handy for these things is I have ways of calculating. I have some brilliant software of what the best benefit to you is given your unique set of circumstances, because these plans, it's not one size fits all. There needs to be the right plan for you and your situation.
I'll tell you something, if you're in business, small size businesses, you like to work with them. You work with all businesses, but you do like to work. And I want to say this, so many people today, they think they can find all the information out that they need on the internet. And it's very important that you have somebody like Anna who's looking out for you. I think that is what I love about you. And having that CPA, you don't have to have a large business. You don't have to be making tons and tons of money. When you say the word CPA, everybody thinks, oh, you know, that's not the case. Go ahead and tell them what you think.
Yeah, I believe it's really important. I had a client who, and I said had because it kind of ended badly, when she was doing her retirement planning, she didn't include me in on the discussions. And it ultimately didn't end well because she chose a plan that she couldn't afford. And would have given her a big tax break, but it wasn't meaningful because her business wasn't as profitable as she thought it might be. But she didn't include me in on it, didn't have me do any year-end projections, you know, look at the books in October like I suggest that I do, or November. And, you know, when she didn't include me, that ultimately hurt her.
Right, and so here's the thing. You do, and not, most people that would have a CPA that just talks to you once a year, that's not really very good. You want someone like Anna who is going to be there for you, and you can talk to her. You're open to it. You want them to, as a matter of fact. Absolutely, so that she can help you. First of all, making the right decision, like something like that was detrimental to her, obviously. And, of course, you know, when you have someone like Anna that's helping you make those decisions, you're going to be feeling much better about things. You're going to have confidence about what you're doing and know that you're doing the right thing. Her phone number to call direct, it's 480-964-4030. That's 480-964-4030. She's rated with the Better Business Bureau. Check her out on her website. It is ArizonaCPAsWithAnS.com. Hang tight. We're going to be back in just a minute.
Tired of paying high hourly fees when you need a plumber?
With COVID.
Dover Plumbing, you get the same great service as the other guys, but you pay by the job, not the hour. So if you have a residential plumbing issue, don't wait. Call Cobra Plumbing today. Plus, our work is guaranteed. So call us today for your free estimate. Call 602-663-8432. That's 602-663-8432. To see a list of our complete service offerings, go to cobraplumbing.net.
If you'd like your granite and marble to get back to that brand new look, call King's World of Marble. The word in the valley is if King's World of Marble can't repair it, nobody can. With 40 plus years of experience, King's World of Marble can repair, restore, and maintain all natural stone within residential and commercial spaces. The market is full of stone countertops and flooring, so King's World of Marble with a 5-star rating is truly the best to repair the damages the right way. Call 602-451-2689, 602-251-2689, or visit kingsworldofmarble.org.
KFNX Cave Creek.
Hi, this is Nick Magallanes, loan officer with Price Mortgage. For all those out there that have questions surrounding the purchase and refinancing of not just residential, but commercial, land, construction, and many other facets, I am here to answer all of your questions. We have the capability to shop with over 117 lenders. For more information, pricemortgage.com, or you can call me directly, 602-621-3061.
Nick Magallanes, loan officer, NMLS, 1853487. Price Mortgage, LLC, NMLS, 142-9043, equal housing lender.
Do you have a parent, grandparent, or loved one who needs some extra help? Senior Helpers has spent 16 years helping seniors continue to live at home as they age. Do you have a loved one needing help with grocery shopping, meal preparation, or even help taking a shower? Call Senior Helpers today at 480-621-6672. We specialize in helping seniors with Alzheimer's and dementia, Parkinson's disease, and other chronic illnesses to stay at home. You can find us online at seniorhelpers.com or at 480-621-6672.
What if I told you that getting Medicare coverage doesn't have to be a complicated process? Are you tired of being confused with the many coverage options available to you with Medicare? At Tapestry Insurance Group, let us help by taking the confusion and complication out of your Medicare options so you can get the coverage you need. Some available plans have no additional premium and may help lower your out-of-pocket costs. There's never a cost for a consultation with one of our licensed agents, so don't delay. Contact us at 602-541-7656 or visit tapestryinsurancegroup.com.
Are you tired of dealing with incontinence? Do frequent trips to the bathroom keep you up at night? Sudden urges when you laugh, cough, or sneeze? VJuve's non-invasive treatments for men and women are covered by insurance, Medicare, and FDA approved, making them accessible to everyone. Say goodbye to discomfort and embarrassment, and hello to a happier, healthier you. With several locations throughout the valley, there's one nearby. Why wait any longer? Schedule your complimentary treatment today at stopthep.com or call 480-593-5400. Let VJuve make you a better you. If I traded
it all. So welcome back. We are talking with Anna von Straussenburg, and she's the owner of L. Anna von Straussenburg CPA. And we were talking during the break about, you know, tax planning and retirement planning. And you also said that you wanted to talk about foreign income.
Well, you know, this was a subject. It's funny how sometimes I'll come across a subject matter in a couple of different ways, and one of the ways that this came up is actually somebody was referred to me, and they're moving out of the country, and they wanted to know how their income was going to be taxed when they're a resident of another country. The other way it came up is I just happened to see in a newsletter, and I don't know if it was the IRS, or I think it might have been even my own newsletter. I have, it's generated by another company. And that, you know, what do you do with retirement planning if you're going to live overseas? And that's what really gave me some ideas. And those ideas always kind of come to me in multiples. And so I thought, well, this is a good subject to talk about. Because, you know, there is a foreign exemption when you live in a foreign country and you have earnings, and especially earnings from that foreign country, you can, if you meet the certain criteria, and there's a lot of different criteria to meet, it's not really easy, you can exempt up to $120,000 of income plus some living expenses.
Wow.
And then there's other ways you can reduce your U.S. tax liability because, you know, when you're a U.S. citizen, you're taxed on your worldwide income. But then if you have earnings in the foreign country that are from the foreign country, you can also, you know, you end up paying tax on that. Well, there's foreign tax credits you can take too. So there's another place where you really need to seek out an a qualified CPA like myself, because you know, you need to know what all these complicated rules are so that you don't fall short and end up paying double taxes.
Well, she said the word, took the word right out of my mouth, which is complicated. You actually thrive on complicated returns.
Oh, that's, you know, that's where I feel I am at my best. I find a challenge just my favorite thing to do. You know, that's when I just get super focused and get things done. When I have something challenging, that's where I think I excel at that, and that's what I really enjoy.
So give an example. Obviously, foreign income is going to be complicated right there.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
But something not as, like something like that could be, maybe you own many properties, maybe some here,
yes,
maybe some out of states. Give us some other ideas.
Well, I do have a number of clients. I have one client that owns a few businesses and a number of rental properties and other types of businesses, and the interesting thing with that is, you know, when people own multiple businesses, they often need to shift money from one to the other or pay expenses on behalf of another company, or, you know, things happen where it's not always cut and dry and nice and clean and pretty as it should be. And I know I established a policy years ago, even when I worked for my former employer. I said, you know, when we have companies that are related entities, when we finish one, we don't release it to the client or the IRS or anybody until we finish all of them, because it never fails that on the last return, there's a transaction that I find in the books that belonged on the first return. And so I hold the returns off, file extensions if I have to, just to make sure that everything is properly accounted for, because, you know, you want to get your deductions, but you want to take them in the correct company, because, you know, if those companies are ever audited and you take the deduction for the wrong company, and, you know, they disallow it, and then they may not allow it in the other company. It's very strange how the IRS works. So, you know, doing the tax returns is accurately as possible is super important.
Absolutely, and that's where you come in. You have a sharp pencil, you are a researcher. You go over these over and over and over again to make sure they're done correctly. You stand by your work. You're all about excellence and integrity in accounting.
Yeah, our policy in the office, we have one person do the preparation, you know, actually put the numbers in the tax return, and then we always have a second person review it. And generally, that's one of my other staff members, so that I am the last person to see it. And so it gets three sets of eyes on it.
Mm-hmm.
And actually, with my administrative assistant, who was so wonderful, it actually gets four sets of eyes, because she's the one who scans the documents. She's the one who prints out the tax returns. And so if she sees anything that looks odd to her, she brings it to my attention.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, we're all on our toes looking out to make sure that everything is as accurate as possible.
You know, I'm not sure if this was the last time I saw before your ribbon cutting. You recently just had a ribbon cutting. Congratulations on that. You were supposed to do that like even a couple of years ago, but then COVID happened.
Yeah, COVID happened, and then some employee changeovers happened, and unfortunately the employee market has been very difficult, but I finally found some wonderful people to help me. One was actually a former coworker that I've kept in touch with all these years, who had retired, but she came out of retirement to help me. And then I found this wonderful lady, Bonnie, that's a snowbird from North Dakota, who was down for the winter time, and she was looking for a job, and she had great she's a CPA and had great experience. She was an auditor for the Air Force.
Oh, wow.
And so sharp as a tack. Wow. And then I got Linda. Well, you know, other than Bonnie, the other three of us are about 5 feet tall.
And we're all,
and I won't give our ages out, but we're all over the age of 60.
But you've been in business for a very long time, yeah, and you're here to help. You know, it's the summertime. I was just trying to remember what I was thinking of saying, but it is the summertime, and it is a great time right now. Look how fast this year has gone by. Everyone I talk to cannot believe that it's July.
Oh, my goodness.
It's just crazy. And so right now when you say, okay, well, it's the summertime, and, you know, things slow down, they just automatically do. What a great time to make sure that you are taking care of your tax planning, because it's going to come back up so fast. It always does. Go ahead.
Well, it's funny because I just read a line in the newsletter from the IRS, and it says, you know, tax planning doesn't just happen in tax season. Tax planning should happen all year round.
Right.
And they said, you know, it's important to keep track of your things that, you know, maybe deductions, your medical expenses. And by the way, something like
Daniel,
those things, when it's for medical reasons, even alternative medicine is tax deductible.
See? Wow. So there, it's awesome.
Yes.
It's awesome.
Yes.
You know,
yes.
And when you think about that, because a lot of people, they shy away from that because they have to pay cash. Well, so you pay it up front, you get to take it off of your taxes.
Yeah,
that's
so
awesome.
So that saves you something. And I'm a big proponent of using different kinds of medical, so I've researched it for my own purpose because I wanted to know what I was paying my naturopath.
I bet you a lot of people didn't know
that. Was deductible, and it is.
But where else but on Networking Arizona would you know and hear about the fact that if you go to a naturopathic, you can get that, write that off on your tax return. That's pretty awesome. And so what else would you leave with people for today? What else do you want to talk about?
Well, Daniel's asking me how much. Well, it depends. When it comes to medical deductions, you have to meet a threshold of 7.5% of your adjusted gross income. And then, you know, whether or not you married filing separate or married filing joint or single, then you have to, in order to get the benefit of that deduction, you have to get over your standard deduction limit. But, you know, things like insurance, health insurance, and a lot of people pay their own health insurance, and that's also deductible. So there's a lot of things that add into that number. So that's why it's really beneficial to come to a CPA, because you might disregard some of those things. And I always ask those questions. I am so nosy when it comes to somebody's taxes.
Well, nosy is good when it comes to this. I really quickly also like to end with this too. You know, a lot of people do their own. They always do. But what you do have helped people get money back that they didn't realize either they paid into too much. And you said almost every single time I look at somebody's return as a second set of eyes, you find money that they could be getting back.
I definitely have. I can't think of one that didn't. And one of my good friends actually came to me as a client when his CPA retired, and he told me his story. He said, well, I started using a CPA to do my taxes because I was doing my own, and I came up 1 year, and he goes, I was owing a lot, like $2,000. I took it to a CPA. The CPA found some things he was missing. He said, not only did I not owe that, I was getting a refund. And so he's been telling all my friends about it, and so I've had a nice influx of people that I know coming to me to do their taxes, because he says, hey, you know, Anna knows what she's doing.
Absolutely.
And she'll save you money. And I've had other people come, say, hey, I'm not sure if I'm doing it right. People who are smart, you know, computer programmers, etc. They're smart people, but they don't know income taxes. And I've found that they ended up getting refunds when I looked at their return.
Well, it's right now a great time to call her and have a free consultation. Her phone number direct, it's 480-964-4030. That's 480-964-4030. She does free consultations. She works nationwide. She's rated with the Better Business Bureau. She's all about excellence and integrity in accounting. Give her a call. This is a great time to get your tax planning done, retirement planning. Get, if you are also, if it is a little complicated, she loves to work with you. Not that I